Yo, Guido. Que paso?
Oi, D, you're home. How was Hollywood?
Muy bien, crazy ass. I met with some big shot studio execs about rebooting the Hello World program in CG and, get this, 3D.
What?
Listen, hombre, puppets haven't been cool since the Pee Wee Herman incident in 2011. The future is digital. Star Wars, Transformers, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, even Gremlins.
What? Gremlins? But puppets are still relevant. What about the Muppets? Noel Fielding's luxury comedy. Or Super Users, the legendary GNU/Linux show.
Never heard of them. Look, Guido baby, there's a precedence for conversion from analog to digital formats. Take a closer look at your comic book. They were originally printed on paper using Benday dots. Check it out. Digital images use pixels to form 2D images on a screen. Pixels are so small that when you look at them from a distance, you don't notice the individual points. Each pixel can be changed to a different color by setting the RGB value. RGB stands for red,
Guido,
green, and blue. Each color can have a value between 0 and 255. This pixel is red, so its RGB value is 255.00. A red value of 255 means this pixel is the reddest red that it can possibly be. A blue and green value of 0 means this pixel is not at all blue or green. If we increase the blue and green to 255, our pixel will appear white because in the light spectrum, white is a combination of all colors. If we reduce the red, green, and blue value to 0, the pixel becomes black, because in the light spectrum, black is the absence of color. My favorite color is 0, 195, 248.
And my favorite color is...
Let me guess. Green.
No, it's chartreuse.
A pixel can also have an alpha value that determines how transparent it is. An alpha value of 255 means the pixel is opaque. You can't see through it. An alpha value of 0 means the pixel is completely transparent. You can't see it at all. Images are grids of pixels organized in rows and columns called the X and Y axis. The Y axis is up and down, and the X axis is left and right. If that's too hard to remember, then Y is up, X is across. As we move down the Y axis, the Y value increases. And as we move right on the x-axis, the x-value increases. So this chartreuse dot here is located at x8, y5.
Y8?
No, y5.
I mean yx8. Why not 9?
Oh, no. Much like the Cartesian coordinate system, computer graphics have an origin point at 0, 0. So this first pixel is actually x0, y0, not x1, y1.
Hold up. If I know my René Descartes, wouldn't that make the coordinates for this pixel x8, y, negative 5?
That's where it gets tricky. This y-axis is flipped, so we can deal with positive numbers. Think of it as a Cartesian plane where the bottom right quadrant represents a digital display. We could position pixels outside of this quadrant using negative coordinates, but then they wouldn't be visible to us. It will make more sense if you try drawing something. It's Utah.
Hmm, so it is.
It's a great place to visit, but I wouldn't want to live there. Did you know that important developments in computer graphics took place at the University of Utah?
Such as?
Such as this teapot. Like the name of our show, it's a Hello World object for CG artists. They use it as a quick reference to test scene and light setups for rendering.
Rendering? Like fat?
Ew, no. In computer science, rendering is the process of creating a 2D image from a 3D model. The teapot may look flat, but it's composed of points in space.
That's hecka cool. Where's it going?
To infinity and beyond.